Warning, this review may contain spoilers, strong language, violence, and content of a graphic nature. It may not be suitable for some viewers. Viewer discretion is advised.
I'm DJ Surreal with Descent Sundays, Vancouver's Gothic alternative event. Welcome to Trick or Treat Horror Fest. Throughout the month, I will release a horror movie review, every day. So stay tuned, because today is going to be our first one. So our first horror movie is our namesake, Trick or Treat. It's put out in 2007, and just before we get into the details of the movie, got a trailer for you.
The spookiest time of the year, there are a few guidelines all ghosts and goblins should follow. Always stay on sidewalks, never go to a stranger's house, and never go out alone.
Sorts of things. Roam free. Sorry. All these traditions.
Wait.
What?
You're supposed to keep it lit.
Why?
Ain't your tradition?
Putting on costumes.
I look like I'm five.
You look great.
What did we do now?
We meet our day.
Jack-o'-lanterns.
Why are we here?
To pay our respects to the dead?
The Halloween school bus massacre.
Started to protect us, but...
Morning, guys. How are you doing down there?
Hiding bodies?
Nowadays, no one really cares.
This one's the lit.
Get the hell out of my...
What is that?
It's them.
Respecting the customs, not breaking them.
Actually, probably one of my favorite Halloween movies. It doesn't have a specific plot line, but more you follow the events of several characters on one night, and it sort of bounces around in timeline, but it's kind of interesting too, because characters from other stories that happen on the same evening, you see them in the background of different timelines, and it sort of helps you piece together the overall flow of the evening. And the general idea of the movie is about respecting Halloween traditions.
You're supposed to keep it lit.
Why?
Ancient tradition?
Basically, all the people in the movie who don't respect Halloween traditions end up having horrible things happen to them. Putting it mildly. There's lots of fun little things. This is not a very serious movie, and it's not meant to be super serious. It's very lighthearted and very fun, but it is kind of graphic in some parts. Some parts of it are a little gory, so just be forewarned. The movie has lots of fun little details. Some of the stories are actually, well, a good amount, actually no, probably like two of the stories are actually pretty closely related. And they all tie into each other because it's all about characters within the town. But it's not necessarily something that you specifically pick up on. In fact, one of the stories is about the neighbor of one of the characters, and he doesn't like Halloween, and he when kids come to his door, he sends his dog out with a costume to scare them away, and then he laughs about it, and he doesn't give out any candy or anything, and he's kind of a grumpy old man, and he doesn't like to be bothered. Well, in one part, his history is actually related in another story told by one of the other characters about a bus driver who drives a bunch of special needs kids into a lake. And you don't necessarily immediately make the connection that it's the same guy. It's very subtle little touches, like a ring on his hand, photos he's burning. So I like that little subtlety to it. I enjoy that when they don't beat you over the head with, this is the same guy. So for me, that was really great. There's also lots of funny little jokes, like Anna Paquin is in this film, and she is going with her sisters to a party. And the party is actually at a meadow called, I believe it's Sheep Circle or something like that. And the funny thing is that throughout the movie, you actually discover they're werewolves. And when you first meet them, they're buying costumes and dressing up. So it's very much like the wolf in sheep's clothing going to their party where they all turn into werewolves and devour their dates. And it was actually a little extra funny because Anna Paquin in particular, they dressed up in Little Red Riding Hood, which I thought was, you know, kind of funny. And it's a funny little thing. So yeah, there's lots of little clever things to this movie. And as you follow basically four different stories, you also see this like little, he looks like a little kid, but he's like this little pumpkin head. And you sort of discover throughout the movie that he's not actually a little kid. He's like really like an evil, I think he's supposed to be the spirit of Halloween. Because he's the one who sort of does a bunch of bad things to people who aren't respecting traditions. So in summary, Trick or Treat, total treat. I would highly recommend it. It's a great Halloween movie, and I thought it was a great way to start off our reviews. So thanks for joining me, and I'll see you tomorrow for another horror movie Trick or Treat movie review.